In alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen huwa alladhi ja'alana muslimina wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulil kareem wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ahdahu la sharika lah wa ashhadu muhammadan abduhu wa rasul. Bye bye. You thought it was going to be in English, didn't you? Just kidding. The subject we want to talk about, I think, is one of the ones that very popular on the internet, popular amongst a lot of those who like to go out and share Islam for the first time with people and talk about the subject of science, the science and Islam. We just did a series of television shows, finished them up today, alhamdulillah, with the channel, is it 55? 55 here in Bahrain. And we were talking, one of the programs talking about this subject of science and Islam. And the way the question comes is that actually in other religions, they have a problem with scientists. They have a problem because scientists are saying this, but this religion is saying something totally different. So for the most part, if you want to be religious, you go to your church, you go to your temple, you go in there and be whatever. But when you come out, you need to leave that in there. And when you come out, you need to be a scientist or be modern or whatever, because the two don't resolve. They don't really work too good together, right? So how does Islam look at science? And what's our reaction? You know, can we deal with science? That's the way the question usually is put to me. Some Catholic priests even ask, how do you guys deal with the problems that we have with science? And I tell them, oh, you didn't know? It's Muslims who invented science. We are the first ones. And they look at you like, what? What are you talking about? Okay, what is science? Science is to discover, to be able to... Somebody's playing with the microphones. Okay? You need to put the levels down before they get up and start squealing, because I don't like that. This never fails. Somebody always has to do this. Make sure that we don't make them squeak. It hurts my ears. Thank you. Still echoing. Where's the control at? It loses the effect of the program when this thing starts going and you're like, oh. Okay. Oh, I see a lot of ladies are standing in there. I think there's some seats in here for the ladies. You need to let them come in and sit down. So let's come back now to our subject. We're talking about science. We're talking about Islam or religion in general. And I just made a weird statement when I said that actually the Muslims are the ones coming up with science to start with. And what is science if it isn't to seek out the truth about a matter? Isn't that basically what you're looking for? If you're a scientist, you are seeking truth. You are really looking to find information. True? Not really. That's the concept in the beginning. But when truth flies in the face of some of the stuff you want to believe, then you do the same thing that people in religions do. The scientists of today are not like the scientists of the time when it really kicked off. They're not. Today, a lot of the so-called scientists have a preconceived notion that they start with, and then they want to build their so-called theories off of that. That's true. But when real scientists first started this concept, it was to do what? Take a clean sheet of paper, nothing on it, no preconceived notion, and let us find what we can find to be true and provable, testable evidence, and that is what we'll start with, and we'll build off of that. And that's the way it originally started. And I'm going to show you the time, inshallah, God willing, that it all began. It began 1400 years ago with an ordinary looking man in a very ordinary looking place in the desert. Just a normal, his average height, average build, and I'm talking about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But inside he was a giant, we'd say that right away. But on the surface, a normal person. He was well liked. He was well thought of. And listen to the nicknames that people gave him since he was a boy. One of the nicknames that they gave him was the Truthful. That was a nickname that they gave him, the Truthful. Another nickname they had for him was the Trustworthy, the one you could give a trust to and you'd never break a trust. And he never lied. He also never indulged in some of the common practices of the people that by our standards today would be totally out of it. Most of the people, if not all of them, drank, and a lot of them were alcoholics. They were very horrible in their treatment to women. In fact, they treated a dog better than women, and they didn't like dogs. Stop and think about what I just said. That's bad. It was so bad that if a girl was born to the family, it was considered, now we'd use the word today, a put down. Something, oh, a shame, or in Arabic, aib. So they would take them to the desert and bury them alive. Am I telling the truth?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. That's what I heard, anyway. Yet, amongst all of this, there was one person, his personality was like a shining light above everybody else in his character, his behavior and his demeanor. It was to the extent that people, when they saw him coming, they would be happy. They would just be happy because they knew this is a guy that's not going to be oppressive. He's not going to hurt anybody. They could trust him with anything. And listen to this. Another thing those people used to do, they used to have these feuds. You know what a feud is? Where a whole, it's not just like, I'm going to fight you. No, no. My whole family's going to fight your whole family. And if that's not good enough, I got cousins that are coming in too. And you have relatives and friends that are going to, you know, we're going to make a big thing out of it. Have you ever heard of a camel race? National Geographic's one time they showed it and they had pictures in their magazine. Camel race. The whole desert looked like it's covered with ants. And there's all these camels traveling, you know. They had those for centuries. Well, there was a camel race one time. At the end of the camel race, the camel that won, a boy killed it because he was angry that his camel didn't win, so he picked up a rock and killed the camel with it. So the people that owned the camel, they killed the boy. And the people who had, you know, that had this boy killed, then they began killing those people and they killed them. And this went on for 40 years. Some of the people in the end killing each other didn't even know what started it all. So by the way, if anybody tells you something about Islam is teaching people how to, you know, be at war or fight, no, no, it's impossible. Because the people that Islam came to already knew all of that stuff. In fact, they were experts at killing each other. Some said some of the Arabs were born with a rock in their hand, ready to go to war. But here was a man who didn't even go out and brawl and fight or any of those things. He was a person who was kind, nice, and listen to this. When they're so loud and boisterous and all that they did, you know, he was quiet and peaceful. Peaceful. Gentle. Everybody knew him. They just said, oh, we know this man. This is the man, the praised one. He's the praised one. The people praised him, and his grandfather had a feeling, or a hunch, sort of, maybe. And that's why he called him that, called him the praised one. Oh, do you know how to say that in Arabic? Hamd is praise. Hamd. And the praising one, or the praised one, is Muhammad. That's how he got his name. And he sure lived up to that good name, didn't he? By the way, a little side tip. When you have children, give them good names. They might just live up to be what you said. But don't give them bad names. Who knows what they'll do to you? Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was such an inspiration that even when there were tribes that were fighting with each other, they used to take their property and put it with him. And let him keep their property until they were through fighting, and then they could go get it back from him because they knew that he was trustworthy. Now check this out. Even if they were fighting his tribe,